All right, here's the deal. I have this lathe, and as you can see, it is really short. Don't like working on it because I have to get really low. Wobbles a lot. So, time to build something new.
All right, look at this hot mess. Concept. Lathe, drawers, storage, legs, space underneath, a back, a little suction thing. It goes over here. Here are some measurements. Front, top, side. We're gonna build out the frame and the top, and then we'll worry about the drawers and this thing right here afterwards.
Practically the end. The same height as my outfeed table. Alright, we got that figured out. Although, in all honesty, I probably could have done this again, but it's done. Cutting and milling at once. Let's get all the other stuff milled up. This is going to get me my legs, and this is going to get me all the support pieces. These boards are kind of wonky. You can see there is a nice bow curve cup. I'm gonna put it, it'll be listed right there. Anyways, instead of trying to flatten this whole piece, I can cut out sections of this, and then I only have to flatten that part, which is a lot easier. Chop this all up and it'll be like magic. Watch. What sorcery is this? All right, I've got everything here. My legs, apron, my side stretchers, the ones that go underneath, and my tabletop. Alright, here is the basic layout of the lathe tabletop. I've got a live edge here, which doesn't matter because it's the front. So this was one board. I had to break it down into 6-inch sections so I could run it through my jointer, make sure it was flat. And these were the end pieces that were on that end, I think. So we're gonna glue this all together, and then motor will sit here. There isn't really any particular reason for this piece back here other than to just have some place to put some stuff and to provide some additional support to the overall workbench, because having the bench built like this wouldn't really provide a lot of strength with what I'm trying to prevent, which is vibration and whatnot. And then in the center here, there's gonna be a little port for my dust collection. Get this glued up, and I got all my other pieces cut to length, and then we'll cut the legs and we'll start doing some more of some tenons and then start assembling.
Layout is so important. It's also a pain in the ass, but it helps clarify some things that you need in order to make sure that you're not making any mistakes.
Son of a bitch! God damn it!
After my finish has had time, grab some steel wool or a cloth, and I will come back and add some wax.
Nice thing about shop projects is it gives you the opportunity to experiment on materials, finishes, methods of application without really caring too much about how it turns out. For instance, I've never put this general finishes water base on oak before. I'm trying the foam brush and the regular brush and the roller, and I'm putting on three coats, and I'm seeing how each one does, how it sands. I sanded it with 320 with my Festool, and I just put a coat of wax on top. It's really natural looking. Try something new, and if it turns out to look like a pile of horse shit, then that's okay, because it's in my shop tray, because there's a lot of finishes out there. And knowing the proper way to apply each and every one of them under the best circumstances with every species of wood can be kind of daunting. So now, let's make some buttons. Being plugged in would help. Now we're gonna go over to the table and clean these up with a little hand. That middle section didn't want to take as neatly. All right, so now we're gonna drill some countersunk holes. So, buttons are a way to secure your tabletop to your base, and it allows for the expansion of the wood. Sits on the outside. How's the back of my head? Does it look good? Drawers are in place over there. Gonna cut out the pieces and hopefully make stable flat drawer face pieces with them. Now you can see there's a lot of boards here. I only need 5 boards. 1, 2, 4 and an extra as I cut them out. And I got all this other stuff. Since I'm here and I'm running through the process with my offcuts, my scrap, my waste, I always process it as well so that if it's going to move, it has the opportunity while it sits on the shelf. For me, it just makes more sense to process it now, remove the waste, store it more efficiently than to just save a bunch of these pieces, throw them away because some of them might be used for something in the future. it's done. At least, it's mostly done. It's as done's gonna get for the time being, based on priorities. All right, let's just talk about some ease of use things. Reezy access. Easy access to reach. I was trying to say reach and easy at the same time. I've got my five drawers. Yes, I'm using little coat hangers for drawer pulls. This is what I have, and I'm working with what I got. I've got my little storage area down here. I got my little trash bin and other blanks. Lighting is important. Got me a nice bright light right here. It doesn't have everything I wanted. I still have to figure out how to get this thingy. To affix itself in various locations. For the time being, I lock it right here when I'm sanding. Works well enough. I made a little port thingy. It was a disaster. Did some weird ass laminating stuff around a port. And look, it just became a pain in the ass. And so I decided to scrap it. I just put a board in there to cover it for now. So turning's new to me. I've only done a handful of things. If you want to see, me turn a bowl out of hickory, it gets really shiny, it's nice and pretty. We'll put something right there.